How frustrating is it when you're just going about your day and you try to use a tool you use all the time and yet nothing happens? Well, the quickest way to solve a problem like this is to first understand that unless CAD or your computer is frozen, something always happens. With CAD, we can always check the command line. Any tool we try to use will output info here. Lo and behold, we appear to be getting something when using our tool, and it's an unknown command error. Since LandFX is a plugin for CAD, if LandFX doesn't load properly, CAD won't understand what any of our tools are, hence the unknown command output. There are a few potential solutions for this particular error. We'll start with verifying the LandFX.vlx file, which is essentially the main LandFX application file. To do that, first let's close out of CAD. Then we need to go into our LandFX folder and look for the LandFX.vlx file. Note that if you don't see the .vlx, but do see a LandFX file, you'll need to first turn on file extensions. Once that's turned on, we'll just rename the original to .old or similar, and then we'll rename the .bak version back to just .vlx, then we'll start CAD back up. The next solution we're going to look at is going to be to reinstall the FX Workstation component. This will essentially reload all the LandFX menu files to ensure the commands are named correctly programmatically if using the ribbons, and update the path to your FX server installation. The simplest way to do that is to right-click the Start button here, go to Apps and Features at the top of the list. Once that opens up, we're just going to look for and remove FX Workstation only. With that uninstalled, we can now reinstall it. We just need to go to the LandFX folder and run setup_fxworkstation.exe. You want to run this from your LandFX folder as it auto-populates the required info based on this location. Now, if the previous steps did not help, next we're going to verify the connection between CAD and LandFX. For AutoCAD users, you'll type appload in the command line and load the file landfx.vlx. Since we're using FXCAD though, we're going to pull up our support file search paths and verify the path to our LandFX content is correct. If that path is missing, you'll want to hit Add and then browse to your LandFX folder. Since our path is here, we'll close out of options and try manually loading the LandFX plugin by typing parenthesis load space double quote LandFX.vlx double quote end parenthesis. If the VLX doesn't load here, it's very likely something went wrong in the first step of renaming the VLX file. The next thing to check is your AutoCAD security settings. These prevent plugins from loading that aren't in your trusted paths depending on the setting. There's two options here. We can either disable secure load if you don't want the potential to run into this issue with other plugins, or you can hit add to add the path to our LandFX folder. Once that's done, we can run that load landfx.vlx command again, and verify whether the LandFX plugin now loads correctly. If we're having trouble loading the VLX file, another thing we can do is verify whether CAD is even able to find the file in question. The way we do that is with another command. This time we're going to use parenthesis find file space double quote landfx.vlx double quote end parenthesis. If we get a nil result here, that means the VLX file was either renamed incorrectly or the path is incorrect. We'll need to go back to the previous steps and verify your path is correct and the file is named correctly. Double check that you have file extensions turned on. Now, if the VLX file is named properly and exists in a folder listed in our support paths, we should see that location reflected with the find file result.